set up again here.
Are you doing another painting?
I am. I want to keep working on this thing.
What is it?
Page from the Haunted Tank.
It's a tank man.
It is a tank man. All right, so we're going to reinvigorate some of our paints. They haven't fully dried out, so we should be fine. And all right, we are going to pick up where we left off. I'm going to get a little bit more of this slightly darker blue to add some consistency to how the general shows up, because the hands down there got a little bit dark, so we want to make it a little bit more matching. So as you can see, we got the page well in progress, but we've got a lot of work still to do as we add detail and depth specifically. You know, the part that's going to be the most value and probably the most difficult will be doing Jeb himself, more so than even the planes and guns and such. Okay. So, how do we want to approach that, man? That's the tricky part. Let's do a little bit of explosion, and then we'll come back around. Because the explosion will be a quick boost of value. It'll take up a lot of physical space as we paint. Leaving white in the middle. And then we're going to push out from there with yellow, orange, and red. Get a nice stir on some thin orange. We're going to treat this similarly to how we did the explosion around the plane itself in panel number 4. Keep the lighter colors towards the center, and the darker will become more prominent as we come out. Definitely need to put some more water in the red. Too thin. We can start with that, but we're not going to stick with it. Again, these explosion colors will be tempered by the black smoke coming out. Added some nice color depth to the bottom there as we continue to flesh them out. To our explosion gray. This is where the watercolor functionality, I think, will really work out well for us. pure black for now, this is a, legitimately, it's a comic book page, so painting it with my typical dark outline would make sense, but at the same time, I'm really enjoying the watercoloriness of this, so I'm kind of worried about what happens once we get to filling things in. And so that cloudy again. Pull our scratch down a little bit for us.
A pretty good looking bottom panel.
Bottom panel so far. get a little bit of our gunmetal. I'm going to darken that up here, because gunmetal, the metal, will probably be pretty dark and greasy, being part of the landing gear assembly. Hydraulics hose. Still, I want to get up there and do that top panel. That is going to be the big money. It's looking pretty good. So how do we want to do the RAM? Just keep all the text in red? Maybe? Kind of touching up some of the letters that came out light for the dried light. All right. Be doing some fine line work. Because I want to do a dark blue with that. Yeah, take that off. Effects bubbles in panel number one. these are going to be tricky. Actually, these E's trying to keep enough separation. Meow. Zing. Getting some good color in there. I'm gonna need some green to make his lenses. Let's go ahead and take some sap green. Get some sap green up here. It's a lot of water for a little bit of paint. Why green shades? Well, because of the issue of GI combat that I remember having. I happen to have a haunted tank story. That's the color I remember the glasses being, the goggles being. Besides, I think this would be a good color to block out harsh sun. So why not, right? That's actually pretty good. Oh, this is so fun. I am so happy with this. I am really enjoying it. The only problem I have is going to be with that damn ammo box. That's a nice detail. Need to get a little bit more on his helmet. Stir up the red brown. We got into the wet of the glasses, so let's kind of just draw some of that back out. It's okay to have a little coming through because it is over his helmet, so it makes sense that there'd be some color. Yeah, I can work with this. To thin that out a lot. Let's grab a little bit off the page if we can. I want to use a little bit of water on it. I'm in the wrong damn direction, I'll tell you that. Hit that with some white and it'll be fine. Soften those way up. make this bit green because he's actually sitting on top of the tank. Oh. Go for the uniform brown. Fine point and dab it out. That works okay. Get a nice solid brown. For the eyes. Those dry up, we will put a pinprick of black. Okay. Going to black in the mouth. Starting to come together. I'm going to come back to a little bit of sky on panel 2. Around the word balloon. You gonna try your rock thing?
Yes.
How you gonna plan on doing that for 10 hours? Maybe we have to do something to move the mouse for 10 hours. Is that a key we can use?
Space key.
Okay.
Space bar. My character moves. I found the spot.
Okay. Valuable skill. was tempted to leave this a little bit rough. But I wanted to match panel 4 as much as possible. My style may change from painting to painting, but I'd prefer it be consistent within a single painting, at least.
Ratatatatata.
So how do we want to, where's my color wheel? Can I get moved? In the box over there? Might need our color wheel. Color wheel. Alright, well, no time like depressants. Come on. I don't know if I trust that line yet. Okay.
He's starting to pop already.
Ha ha! Yes, yes. But would you say this is a make or break portion of your painting? Absolutely. How can you be so casual? Oh, I'm terrified. But I'm excited. Like painting is a first date or something. Really enjoy it. Makes you nervous. You're excited for the results. You don't want it to end, but you know you can't keep it going forever. At some point, you go to the omelet shop. In my case, the last time I had an actual first date, went to the Mountaineer Family Restaurant. It was a long, long date, so. Trust me, going there at the end of things was a perfectly suitable place to go. It was not a date fail. Though on a bit of restaurant fail, Mountaineer was killed by a road bypass, which made it hard to get to, and eventually just all the business died out off the highway. We'll let those kind of dry up a little bit. Going to keep working on the hand. I'm going to start with the hand, then move back into the face. Feel a little bit more, I don't know, confident with the hand, I guess. not confident, at least a little less worried, I guess is probably the easiest way to say it. That's a new little gun back there.
You get some gunmetal back, you can check them out.
Put a little drop back into the gunmetal. Put a little stirry stir. Might come back with some explosion cloud gray. That is far too wet. Thickness. All right, we'll come back to that. I'm afraid this made him look a little bit more. A little braver than I had anticipated, as opposed to, you know, the fear you can see in the original. Looks angry. It's the eyebrows. That helped.
It is really starting to pop out here.
Again, he looks angrier when I wanted to be more afraid, but still pretty dope thus far.
I am loving this. Timberlake style.
I'll let that rest. I'm going to come back and do a little bit. I'm going to spread the love to the rest of the picture. I'm going to take that with a pen, just because that piece of the paper has been roughed up a little bit. Make a thin line. Okay. Yes. Trying to think of, ooh, there's a big glob of that there we don't need. I'm trying to think of the background for panel 3. goggles in the panel 5 inset. Okay, got a thin line, yes. Adding some depth of black. Do I want to come around the zing and the meow? Yes. But let's work down here. Get a little bit of line. Oop. lines are breaking, so I need some more wetness on that brush. So that's, we've been actually been really judicious with our use of this red. Probably the only paint we've been conservative with this entire time. We could use some purple in here. Is it 3:24? Have some actual work to attend to, sadly. To prepare for another lovely week of work, which is its own unique hell. Day in, day out, there's always something new to be annoyed with or disappointed in. But I guess that is the nature of work. And the reason they have to pay you to be there and to do it. Do they pay enough? Clearly not. Do I know what enough would be? No. Would it be more than what I'm making now? Yes, of course. That's just plain science. That's math. Someone, of course, made the joke of I guess nobody won the Powerball. And I was just like, yep. I doubt this meeting would be as populated as it is had someone won that money. But let's not talk about work. Let's talk about weird comic book paintings. The best weird comic book painting I have is not one of my own. It is a painting I purchased at a flea market at a drive-in. I used to hit yard sales and flea markets fairly regularly when I had time to actively run a store on eBay. I sold pretty much anything I thought would turn a profit, but I focused, of course, on core competencies of nerd shit. Just one more drop on the edge there. Very nice. Yes. WHRAM. RAM. Not to be mistaken with WHAM! Exclamation point, but RAM. You know, next one of these, because this is definitely something I'm going to do again, it's got to be EC, right? Or at least a DC horror title, because painting a horror page, lurid colors, would have to be fantastic. I really cannot comprehend anything other than that. At least for somebody as easily entertained as myself. See, that one, they did not connect. I did. Artistic choice? Maybe. Too lazy to look up from our page? Maybe. Like, maybe. Qbert? I think this is Joe Qbert, right? Wanted the other ones connected and that one not to actually say something about the sound to make it kind of a compound. Yeah, see, that was my worry. On that panel there, it's hard to tell. So we'll darken that up a little bit. Thought I heard some little feet over there.
I didn't.
I didn't? Oh, I must be mistaken.
Also, you want to hear something?
Tell me something.
I've been in the rock for 21 minutes. Mm-hmm. You know what's happened?
Did it disconnect you?
I haven't.
How's that happening?
You know how we put the thing on the jump button?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that fixed it.
Good thinking, good persistence. That's what I like to see. The fact that you stuck with it, man.
It's spam jumping, so like, yeah. I know when it's gonna be done. About midnight. After, like, at 1 a.m.
Well, so long as it's done by the time I gotta start work tomorrow, I'm fine.
Yeah, I'm gonna enter God Gamer in mode. Hey, Daddy.
Yeah.
I was playing Spot Battles on my newest alt account.
Mm-hmm.
Here he is.
What's his name?
Shunkle.
Shunkle?
Yeah. And so I'm playing in no one track was. You know, at the regular Spot Battle server I was in? My main accounts. I was in Sleepy Towers. I don't know why, but I like becoming friends with my alt account.
No.
So I might do that.
That's fine by me.
It's my old account.
Go back to regular time. I'll see if I can in my server. Yes. Yes. Okay. It is really starting to fall into place. Again, as you add the black lines, things start to come together. Don't get yourself kicked out of your thing already.
What?
Don't get yourself kicked out of the rock or whatever it is.
I won't. Tape measure's still on there. I'm still jumping.
I just don't want you to open up like another window or something and boot yourself out. What do we do that panel? You okay there, kid?
Yeah.
What? What's that?
I accidentally swapped the tape measure.
Uh-oh. I get that thing fixed. They don't drop out.
You know why?
Tell me why.
Because I jumped.
Yeah.
I was still... Even though I wasn't jumping, was it 20 minutes since I last jumped?
Yeah.
Bro, I literally stopped jumping like 1 second ago.
So it kept you in there?
Yes. It would disconnect me if I haven't moved in like 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Okay. Also, moving, jumping counts as moving.
I know. I just don't want you to, you know.
So what do we put in that background?
Means that if I do get Robux and I decide to get an Undertale Judgment Day private server, I get wins quicker, I get more kills, and also I get Evolution Game Pass like experience quicker.
Yeah.
So that's good.
Okay. I don't need instructions to know how to rock. The new Aqua Teens movie? It's crazy. I guess I'll watch it if it comes on HBO or whatever. The other day on Twitter, does anyone remember a time in their life when Warner Brothers wasn't cursed?
Warner Brothers was cursed?
They've been under some bad juju for some time, apparently. I guess maybe the last time Warner Brothers was doing great without a lot of corporate shenanigans. Maybe the late 80s, early 90s. And then things really started to fall apart with the AOL Time Warner merger thing. Since then, they've been in trouble. Yep. AOL was an internet company. Back before, you know, you're just always on the internet. You had to use your phone and call another computer to connect. And AOL, or America Online, was a really big provider of that service for quite some time in the mid to late 90s. Well, by the late 90s, they started to come more and more into irrelevance. By the early 2000s, no one wanted AOL, but Warner Brothers merged with them anyways for the only discernible reason I can think of is, money, which is a fair reason, but didn't go well for them then. And the AT&T merger, American Telephone and Telegraph, they are a phone company. Ask yourself, why would a phone company want a media company? And so did a lot of other people.
I know what the answer is.
What's that?
Shmoney.
Yeah, well, shmoney is the answer for most of these questions. They just don't know how to properly make it. harm here. What's cool, kid?
If you stay in the server for like 30 minutes and you're on a rock.
Yeah.
You become a mega rock, but you don't get the badge.
Okay.
So you get to experience being a mega rock, just minus being in a rock for an extra 9 hours and 30 minutes.
I'm confused.
I have to make sand under my own peg.
How are you going to hit him with a stick if you're in a rock?
True. Why did I not think about that? That is so true.
That sounds like sarcasm to me. Oof.
Do you want Robics?
You know what? Oh. It is time to take another stretch break. So our shoulders don't get too tight. Maybe do a little bit of actual work. We'll come back here in a little bit and keep on painting. If not, we will finish up sometime maybe tomorrow. So, again, thanks for joining us. Talk to you again later.